I'm on vacation every single day, cause I love my occupation. Hey, I'm on vacation every single day, every single day. Every single day, every single day.
Guys, feeling love in the air?
Not particularly, no.
Well, you should. It's Valentine's.
Well, it's not yet, but it's coming up, yes.
Have we all taken a moment to sort of ask the big man what the plan is?
What big man?
The big kahuna.
Not ringing any bells, man.
The Cupid? It's a real thing. Demigod comes down, got the bow and arrow. He shoots you in the head, you fall in love, Valentine's Day happens. This is how it began. It will always be about Cupid. It always was about Cupid. Don't act like you don't know.
Chad's a weird guy. I understand what you're saying, but like you're acting like Cupid is like some kind of like Easter Bunny or Santa Claus. Like he's not even on the same level. So, let's think about this for a second. When you're a kid, who do you know? You know Santa. You know the Easter Bunny. Maybe even the Tooth Fairy. Cupid? Do you know Cupid? No, you don't. Chad's wrong. Again.
How are you gonna fall in love? The flapping of the wings, the gentle... Boop!
Riddle me this, Chad. Fourth grade. Everybody got a Valentine's Day in school. I did not. Where was Cupid? Boom.
What is your relationship with Cupid like?
Enough is enough. We're talking about a baby in a diaper that's a grown man. Like, let's move on.
Let's just put that aside and get back to the content.
I don't know what brought this whole thing up, but this is not what we need to be talking about.
So I want to do something good on Valentine's Day, get in the Cupid-y spirit a little bit. My wife, Heather, she told me about a place local called Painterly Potterly. Sounds like fun. We're going to go check it out.
Cupid, stop whispering. He loves the chocolate.
That's really kind of creepy.
Why are you guys so quiet? What are you talking about?
I honestly couldn't even tell you.
So Chad told us about this pottery shop. I've never been here before, but let's go check it out and see if there's something here for Valentine's.
L is for the way you look at me.
Let's get this done.
This doesn't look like a Valentine's place.
There seems to be more stuff everywhere. It's like, look, it says love over.
You know that's a Cupid thing.
So there's a lot of cool stuff around here, but I'm not really seeing something that speaks love.
Just think about it, guys. Think about it.
I see what you did there. That's really nice. This one says it's lit.
When you cry, you can put your tears in there and you can save them. And then a little fairy will come out. There's a lot of different options here. I mean, there's coffee mugs, there's giraffes, like spaceships. But if this is for Valentine's Day, I'm going to do a teacup because my lady likes her tea and my lady's going to get what she wants. So I might actually do this one. It's cheesy, but you know, that's what Valentine's is. It's cheesy.
I know my Heather. She will love this.
Yeah,
this is ideal.
That's hideous.
Nope.
She's gonna hate that. That's the least romantic thing I've ever seen. I'm having a hard time understanding the romantic feels behind this.
It has a strong I come from Michigan vibe.
When I think of love, I mean, the next thing that follows is Michigan.
The speckle paint's down there. Come just like that with the speckles already mixed in.
Digital.
That was the color of your suit.
Exactly.
Caribbean sprinkles.
It's Caribbean.
Shut your mouth.
I'm pretty excited. Oh, you missed a spot.
Oh, no.
So I'm not really an artist, but it's time to paint.
Fresh paint job. Fresh paint job. Lean back, right hand on the firewood. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. Ice cream paint job. Ice cream paint job. Cream on the inside, clean on the outside. Ice cream paint job. Ice cream paint job.
Dude, you're literally painting an island. Don't look at mine.
My wife, Heather, will literally drink out of this 7 times a day.
That's a lot of coffee, bud.
It's good for your digestion.
Oh, I don't need help with that, bud. I'm regular.
You know, you're making the gift. You want it to express love. I think this turned out pretty nice. She's really gonna like this.
There you go.
Wow.
Like, Becca was totally like looking all over him and being like, wow, this is amazing.
So real talk, this isn't what I'm going to get her. Oh, I mean, I am. I'm going to give it to her, but I have something much more special planned. I finally found the person that I want to spend the rest of my life with, and you guys are going to be able to see this live in this episode. I'm super nervous right now, and I just hope everything goes perfect.
the day that I've been waiting for a very long time. Very excited, very nervous. She thinks we're gonna meet my parents at a restaurant in Midland. That is not the case. We are gonna take a little pit stop detour to the Midland Canopy Walk. Now, I've taken her here before and we both love it. She loves the outdoors. And I just thought that this would be the perfect venue to ask the woman of my dreams to marry me. Well, this is it.
So, basically, I just want to say that I love you so much. And I appreciate everything that you do for me. Aww. And I know that I want to spend the rest of my life with you. So, will you marry me?
Yeah.
Alright.
Oh my god, what? Oh my god. Like, what?
I don't want to drop this, so let's put it on right. There you go. Do you like it?
Oh my god!
Oh. Right? So, I'm not having a panic attack, but kind of I am now.
Oh my god!
So we're pretty excited for Trent and Lauren. Congratulations, guys. We're looking forward to seeing you start your lives together.
Seriously, guys, congratulations.
L is for the way you look at me. O.